The reason we decided to move ahead in planning Lausanne 3 in Cape Town 2010 is twofold. Firstly, we believe the gospel message is the greatest message in history. It has to be taken to the ends of the earth. Secondly, the global church hasn't met in this way for 21 years. 1989 was the last time we had a major Lausanne Congress, and we sense it's time for evangelical leaders to gather together from the ends of the earth to unite in their determination to take the gospel to the ends of the earth through any and all means of partnership. And we are trusting that God will raise up many partnerships and fresh impetus and passion amongst those who attend to take the gospel to every territory across the globe. What we're hoping as outcomes from Cape Town 2010 is firstly that the global church will gather together and look at some of the challenges, which are new challenges facing the church since we met in Lausanne 2 in Manila in 1989. We have a host of new challenges facing us, from the issue of AIDS to the issue of climate change to global terrorism. And we want to investigate and look together at how we can proclaim the gospel in that changing cultural context around the world. Secondly, we believe it's very important to give visible unity to the cause of Christ in the church around the world. And we're hoping that as a result of gathering together, many fresh partnerships will come into existence between people who are committed to taking the gospel of Christ to every nation. Thirdly, many people have still not heard the name of Christ, let alone believed on him. And our passion and conviction and desire is that many people will receive a fresh impetus, a fresh desire to take the gospel of Christ to every people and every nation on the globe. Another great challenge facing us is the major world religions of the world, many of which have experienced some resurgence even since the last Lausanne Congress was convened. We see the growth of Islam around the world and of fundamentalist Hinduism, not to mention Buddhism and Confucian influence. In general terms, the Church of Jesus Christ has not made a big dent in those major religious blocs. And we need to meet together to pray, to call out to God, to reflect, to strategize, and to determine fresh ways forward to reach out to people in those major religious groupings around the world.